Okay. So your first name again?
I go by Shonda for short.
Shonda?
It's Le Shonda.
Okay, Shonda. So just share, Shonda, the reason why you came and what you expect the Lord to do.
It's a few reasons why I came, going back to my past. I grew up in a home where my father abused my mother pretty regularly, and I saw that from the age of 3 to the age of 12. When I was about 8 years old, I was molested by a family member, and that opened the door for me. It was a male who molested me, but it opened the doors for females to molest me after that, and I lost my virginity. So fornication came in, and when I became a young adult, I was fornicating, and I contracted something that I still carry till this day. And I know God has been revealing to me that I'm going to get married, and I do not want my husband to pay for my past mistakes. And this all happened before I got saved, but you know. Numbers 32:23, be sure that your sins will find you out. And it's something that I've been carrying all this time. And it's something that I want to be set free and delivered from. And then the spirit of poverty, the spirit of lack, rejection, self-rejection is on me, heavily on me as well. So I want to be broken from the spirit of poverty. Because I am working for God. I left a full-time job last year to start to do the assignment he's calling me to do. And it's every time I try to progress and move forward, the enemy is attacking me, whether it's in my finances or trying to hold unforgiveness in my heart. So that's what I want to be delivered from and set free.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Spirit husband, spirit death, in the name of Jesus, I command you to come out of her. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you. The blood of Jesus commands you to loose her. Take your sickness with you. Take every spirit under your control, living with you, in this body. Bow them to yourself and get out. Get out. Snakes, Jezebel, get out. Come out of her mind, loose her will, come out of her emotions, and come out of her body. For the blood of Jesus commands you to loose her in the luck. Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. Search and destroy darkness that is clinging onto her mind, her will, her emotions, and in her body. Burn every spirit that's in her mind, her will, emotion, and body, and you set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn sickness and disease. Burn those spirits of rebellion. Burn. Burn even in her uterus, in her womb, in her Fallopian tubes, in her private area, in her rectum. Burn deep down in her belly. Go deep, deep down in her belly. Burn all manner of rebellion spirits. Burn. Set this body ablaze. Set ablaze, Holy Ghost. Set ablaze in Jesus' mighty name. Shake this body. Purify this body. Clean this body. Redeem this body. Purify this body. And baptize this body in with the blood of Jesus. In the spirit realm, I take God's sins by cup. Touches her from the ungodly covenant of family adultery and witchcraft. I detaches her, disconnect her from that spirit husband, even spirit wife, all those spirit children, that spirit marriage, that spirit family, every relationship in the spirit realm that Heavenly Father did not connect her to. I disconnect because the blood of Jesus disconnects her. The blood of Jesus forgiving her. The blood of Jesus sets her totally free by his shed blood. Even in this natural realm, every relationship my Heavenly Father did not connect her to, I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. In spirit. Be free in your mind. Free in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotions. Be free in your dreams, in your visions, in your businesses, and all your affairs. Be free. And be free in your body. Serve and worship the Lord. And only when you serve in spirit truly, be free in my Jesus' name. Father, fill me. Fill me to overflow with your fear. Fill her mind to overflow. Fill her will to overflow. Fill her emotions to overflow. Fill her dreams. Her vision, her business affair to overflow, and fear her body to overflow. Holy Ghost, go in her house right now. Go in her house and destroy all kinds of darkness of this running around, hiding right now. Destroy darkness who's in every corner, cracking crevice of that house. Destroy darkness that is in every bedroom, in every bedroom. Your daughter that who's around me, under, over, the front, the foot, on top of the bed, between the sheets and the mat, and your short daughter. Don't leave no area untouched. Even go outside the house. Your short daughter that who's around the house, under, over the house, is underground, under the house. Holy Ghost fire, destroy every object that was thrown on top of the earth. Unburied under the earth, thrown in the waters in her name, her family name. Destroy those evil objects. Destroy every covenant, contract, and agreement written on top of the earth, under the earth, or underwater in her name, her family name. Destroy. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for placing a vision of protection around my dear sister. angels linking themselves around her, placing her in a fiber of protection, bubble protection. Thank you, Father, for restoring his body back to the Father. For your plan, your purpose, your ideal for her, and bring the only birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, his share upon the pain. All is forgiven. All is forgiven, the Lord said. Here's what he's saying. In the try to inject a memory of your past sins. As you hear me tell you before, he's saying, talk to me. In the name of Jesus. Start worshiping him, the Father, for his mercy and grace. He said, all is forgiven. And when the Lord forgives, he forgets. Throw it in the sea of forgiveness, never to be brought up again because he don't remember. But you know that's the deal. You focus on what he said, all is forgiven. All your sins have been washed away. No matter in the natural what you may see happening to your body, that is not true. You remember Jesus cursed that fig tree in the scripture. The moment he cursed it at the root. Life was at the root of that fig tree, not at what you could see on the top of the soil. Life is at the root. If you don't kill the root, the thing is not going to die. If God had, if Jesus Christ had cursed the top of that fig tree and forgot the root, he would came back the next day, fig tree, the top of it would still be alive. Not because the root was not destroyed. But he cursed the root. It takes faith in God to curse the root of a thing. The disciples was looking at the surface, the outer appearance, but their eyes could see. Thought Jesus was crazy. What are you doing? I'm talking about cursing the fig tree. Ain't he seen nothing wrong with that fig tree? But Jesus knew he cursed that root. What happened the next day when they passed by? That's when they believed. Because the surface of that fig tree, it had dried up. Oh no, you don't believe when the thing is manifested. You believe when it is not manifested. The Lord said that problem is no more problem because it's been cursed at the root. Just like that fig tree, it's just a matter of time in the natural realm. It will manifest what happened to the root. So you don't go by the surface. You pray and thank him for cursing that thing at the root. Those who caused that problem was some demon spirits due rebellion, disobedience. But actually, if we go keep going back, fuzzy little girl we were taken advantage of because your parents, the sins of your parents, because they rejected God. They did not have a spiritual covenant with Christ Jesus. So you as a little child, you did not. And once those spirits enter you, which are who are rebellion, spirits of rebellion, they're the one who dictated their will to you. They're the one who worked in your emotions. They're the one who worked in your mind, gave you kind of suggestions in your mind. And those suggestions was things that was in rebellion against God. That's why God love the soul. That's why he said the battle is not against flesh and blood, but against the demon spirit. The Lord said, all is forgiven. You just praise him and thank him. Because there's no more, they're gone. So just share with us what the Lord allowed you to experience.
I felt something like at the lower part, like the lower part of my abdomen. It felt like a foul, like bubbling,
mm-hmm.
and it was like coming up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt that like two or three times. And then like from up here, it felt like I wanted to belch, like something wanted
mm-hmm.
to come up.
Mm-hmm.
When you were just talking to me a few minutes ago, I actually felt
mm-hmm.
it came out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. And that was because God got to the root, but God also had to deal with your faith. So you had to hear those words to build your faith in God, because they were coming out, coming up to come out, but they knew your faith was weak. So they were stuck there. So as God had you to minister the word, see how faith comes by hearing the word of God, it built your faith, because I felt it. It's like it was a great enlightenment. And then that's when that thing didn't have nothing to grasp on, and it had to come up and out. Thank God. He is so good. Dear Lord, we cannot walk by sight. You cannot go by sight. You have to go by faith. Even though there's a few of us in here, God did a mighty work. If he would open up our spiritual eyes and really see what he had done, we'd be like, all of that was going on, Lord. He'll say, yeah. Don't walk by sight. Walk by faith. And God, don't go by your feeling. Well, I don't feel delivered. It ain't no feeling. It's faith. If you go by your feeling, hey, the devil will always let you fail. But you ain't going in God's kingdom by walking by your feeling. It's your faith in God. Amen. Praise his holy name.